sports. It's in the game.
We attacking, better stand back and watch a run. Shotgun come with the options. Send big blitz, nobody blocking. Big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he come in the slot. Trying to bend the corner, your limbs getting. That's your partner, then your twin game. All you want to do is talk, I don't need talk.
I don't hear somebody talk.
Banging my chest and my head on the lock. Feeling like walking flock of flame. I put the opposition out the game. I'm out of pocket, but I rock with the game. We attacking better.
NFL is on EA Sports, and we are in Silicon Valley at Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara. The scene a short time ago, this crowd, they love their 49ers, and they were in full roar as their guys burst out of the locker room. And we're ready for football as the 49ers get set to do battle with the Baltimore Ravens. On the return, Devin Duvernay. And taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line. Now Jackson taps this forward jet sweep. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down, second and right at a yard.
And that's something you have to get ready for defensively, because in today's NFL, teams will use their wide receivers on jet sweeps, end arounds. They'll move them back in the backfield and make them running backs. Partner, this was much more of a tap pass, but effective nonetheless.
And I think both guys love it. If you're a quarterback, it's an easy completion. If you're a wide receiver, you get the easy reception and also a chance to try to make a play with your feet.
Not enough there for a first. No gain, as a matter of fact. And it leaves them at 3rd and 1. Just play number 3 here on the opening drive, and it's an early 3rd and 1. They'll try to run for it with Dobbins. Room here to run. And finally they get him to the ground, but it's all the way down at the Niners' 37-yard line. A big gain there on 3rd and long.
Well, partner, that's one of the problems when you sell out to stop the run on 3rd and short. Sometimes you break the initial wall and you go a long way.
So how do you prevent it?
That's tough to do. That really is tough to do. And one of the things offenses like to do nowadays in practice, you know, they do a lot of working against equal numbers. They'll start putting more and more numbers on defense and just telling the offensive guys, figure it out, learn how to block it. We may see this situation.
And he'll maneuver his way forward for about 4, 2nd and 6.
That was a particularly nice play, because not only was it his job to force the play inside, he was actually able to fold inside himself and make the tackle ultimately. Very nicely done.
The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. And now Jackson will look to throw it. And this is caught by Watkins.
And he'll work free from one tackle, but that's about all as he's taken down.
Nice methodical opening drive here. They're already into field goal range. They're in a good spot. You know that people like to take a shot in this part of the field. But at the same time, as methodical as they've been, they might want to run the ball a little bit here, too.
And just on the outskirts of the red zone, they have options now. Either way, though, they've come out with a purpose. And he will have a Ravens first down. At least it appears that way. And he got it by maybe the length of a football. They'll throw on first down with Jackson. Escaping the pressure right. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the two.
On that play, as you saw the route start to develop downfield, I got the sense that maybe the run would set up for him. And he took full advantage of it and got a big gain on a busted play.
They'll look to run with Edwards. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
So often you hear that pep talks don't really work in the heat of the battle, but collectively, this defense has to say to each other, we've been on our heels this whole first drive. This is where we need to dig in. And they got a nice stop right there for a loss on first and goal.
Dancing to his left. And just shy of the goal line as he's out of bounds right at the one. He'll wind up with positive yardage. It's a gain of three, but now it's third down. Jackson will keep it, and he will take it in for a Ravens touchdown. Lamar Jackson keeping it himself from a yard out. And the Ravens take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. Justin Tucker for the extra point. And the Ravens lead it 7-0.
Makes the score Ravens 7, 49ers nothing.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Garoppolo going to bring the Niners up here first and 10 at their 25-yard line.
Check 26, check 26.
And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. Two yards the loss, second and 12.
A loss of two brings up second and 12 at the 23-yard line.
They'll try the left side. Mitchell. Oh, some strong running. And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. And they'll run on the inside handoff. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. He's obviously a bit of a shorter running back. And sometimes when he goes up the middle like that, he gets lost in there and then he pops out for 10, 20 yards.
I actually asked NFL linebackers if that was true. Do you actually lose sight of some of the smaller running backs? And all of them confirmed that that can be a problem. Think of it this way. Two of the top running backs in NFL history, Emmitt Smith, Barry Sanders, both 5'10".
The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. And here comes throw number 1 for the backup QB. He'll dump that one off to Mitchell. They find some open field here. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds.
This has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
They'll run on first down. Mitchell. And a good gain here of 9 from the 19 down to the 10.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
The last run got 9. That leaves him with 2nd and a yard. And to give this time to the tailback. And here he'll get it down to the 7.
Well, sometimes it's hard to take your eyes off this guy at the linebacker position. He can really cover some ground, and he did there to make that play.
First and goal, and a chance to get that initial touchdown right back. Throwing now is Lance. Incomplete.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap, and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
They'll try the left side. Mitchell. And across the chalk into the end zone. It's a 49er touchdown. Elijah Mitchell taking it in from 7 yards away. And the 49ers are within an extra point of tying this thing up. Gold able to tack on the extra point. And we are tied here in the second quarter. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. Devin Duvernay now returning from the end zone. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offense that's humming.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense getting the ball back.
Oh, into a sea of defenders and intercepted.
Picked off at the 21. So they've got the football, and they'll start right on the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. On first down, it's Mitchell. And he'll take this inside the 20 and down to the 18. The tackle made by L.J. Ford. Right back to Mitchell on second down. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. Second quarter action with 1:59 remaining. Well, they were handed great starting field position on this drive, but now they face a 3rd and 4. On third down, it's Mitchell. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. It's a pickup of 3, but it brings up what will be an interesting 4th and 1. Kyle Shanahan's made the decision. They're going on 4th down. And they'll go for it. Lance. And he's going to have his running back. It's complete. Touchdown! Elijah Mitchell, he scored on the ground and through the air. And the 49ers have now taken the lead. Well, I think, and correct me if I'm wrong, but his top two options were not available on that throw, so he went the safe route, worked out pretty well.
It was like you were in the pocket. How about you going through the progressions like that? What a lot of offenses say, touchdown to check down. Look downfield first, bring it back to the line of scrimmage. Not easy for a rookie to do. Oftentimes they get one look and they make their decision off of that. He went through 3. That was impressive.
After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go.
And he's going to lose a yard or two. Taken down behind the line. After the sack here, 2nd and 11. Off the play fake. Here's Jackson rolling to his right. And he'll be out right at the 35.
Last drive, remember, similar situation. He forced a ball into coverage through the pick. He learned better there.
Yeah, similar to a golfer that's confronted with a shot that you just can't make. Sometimes you have to take your medicine, as they say, right? Just pull it down, take off, and go. Don't make something worse than what it was.
That catch good for only a couple.
Boy, that was certainly well-read defensively. And the key to any screenplay is space to work. And there was none to be found there. And they tackle it for just a short game.
From the 38, Jackson. He'll buy some time right. Going deep here for Watkins. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down.
Certainly no lack of aggressiveness here. They were hoping for the home run play to get them 6 points. They're hoping for a catch, maybe a call, but they figure they can at least get into field goal range with a completion.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves them staring up here at a 3rd and 8. He's going deep for Brown.
Well, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted.
Picked off by the safety, Jarquiski Tart. And the Niners will have the football as this is taken up past the 30. That had disaster written all over. You've got a right-handed quarterback, a rolling left, and throwing it pretty far downfield.
It's really difficult to do, to try and get your body twisted around into the proper position and get anything on the ball as you heave it downfield. And that's what it actually turns into, a heave. And that's not really a good throw, is it?
Not good, and we saw the result. Looking deep for Jennings. And incomplete on the deep ball. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break.
Both these teams, no doubt, making their final halftime adjustments as we speak. And for the call of the second half, we get it back out to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number 3. And how about this line out of the locker room? An onside kick attempt. It's the 49ers out in front, and they will get the football first as well as we are back and started in the second half. A very interesting call and one that backfires. I know they're losing, Charles, but boy, to start the second half with the onside kick, risky.
Felt like a sense of urgency from their side, coupled with, you and I both know, the special teams coordinators. They sell their key plays each and every week to the head coach, don't they? And I guarantee he's been selling this one. We can get it, coach, we can get it. And that came together with that sense of urgency you talked about.
Right back to him on first down. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. 2nd and 10 coming up.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. The turnover put him in great field position. They don't want to squander it with third down coming up.
No, not at all. And you know what else you do? You make your defense mad.
Yeah.
They got you the football, gave you a great opportunity. You got to cash in and get some points.
That's caught out right by Jennings. Jennings lost the football, and it's picked up by the Ravens. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here.
Jackson's throw taken in by Watkins here.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. Jackson gonna get this out to Brown.
And he's able to break out of one tackle, but then quickly brought down. Jackson on the give to Dobbins. And he'll be tackled at about the 35. Third and two. Here's Jackson. Flushed out right. And that is incomplete.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable. And that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they've brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
Forced out to his left. First down and more for Jackson. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. So from inside Niner territory now, this is first and 10 at the 48-yard line. They go play action with Jackson. They'll roll him out right. Oh, for the third time, Jackson going to be intercepted. Picked off by Jason Verrett. And the 49ers will have the football as this is taken up past the 30. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And last drive, obviously not what you're looking for. You've got the lead. You've got to protect the football.
So, in other words, someone got lucky because they've been moving the ball really well and wearing them down. In this case, though, giving up the football doesn't make them very happy. They can't wait to get back out there and atone for it.
Yeah, try to atone for it here on this drive. A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. They'll keep it on the ground. Mitchell, and he'll be upended at the 33 following a gain of 3. And guess what? It brings up third down. Throwing his lance on third down. And this is going to be incomplete. So it doesn't look like they're going to be able to build off the turnover.
Well, the defense certainly did its part. It got them the football. But you're exactly right. It looks like they're going to have to punt this one away. And it's not a turnover, but doesn't it feel like one after grabbing the momentum with the defensive play?
Yeah, and they had all that momentum after getting the football, and now zapped right back in the other direction. That's to his running back, complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Well, that's some kind of effort. When he caught it, I doubted if he could get there. Knew it was going to be close, but credit him. Really good effort.
How about the rack on that play, the run after catch? But most of the time, we think of it as just being an open field and picking up yardage. Sometimes you have to be real physical in order to gain the yardage you need for a first down.
Three quarters in the books. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. Under 10. Lance now to throw. Eluding the pressure right. Man open. That's Deebo Samuel. Touchdown, 49ers. Deebo Samuel, 55 yards. And the Niners use the big play to extend their fourth quarter lead. I think it's fair to say there's nothing that gets a crowd to its feet quite like a big play, and that was something special there. Boy, was he moving.
And I'll tell you what a bird's eye view I've got here, because that was absolutely something else to watch. Not a lot of wiggle in that. That was catch it and go, and he used those wheels of his to absolute devastating effect.
And if you're looking for proof of his speed, Next Gen Stats shows that he was traveling just over 21 miles an hour there. After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away. Oh, the return is Duvernay. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And 3 interceptions in this game. I would have to think, I wasn't a quarterback, but number 4 is kind of, oh, you're like, oh, man, I can't throw 4.
No, and what's interesting is, what do the coaches decide to do now? having thrown three, do you alter your offensive strategy? Do you take the ball out of his hands and maybe turn to the running game? Or do you have that supreme confidence that he's going to turn things around?
We'll see what they do. Throwing now, Jackson on first down. Flush to his right. First down and more for Jackson. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30.
Partner, it's often the man coverage is easier for a quarterback to run against. You get your receivers going downfield, those guys are staying with them, and oftentimes they have their back to the quarterback, which opens up a lot of space and room, and they don't even know that he's taken off with it. What a big-time pickup on that play.
Jackson now off the bootleg. Steps away to his left. And this is caught. It's Brown. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10.
Good yardage on the completion there. And when they look at the scoreboard, they do understand a field goal is not going to do them any good. My guess, they're going to press the ball downfield as far as possible, try and throw it into the end zone and get a score, because they know they've got to get that done and get the ball back as quickly as possible.
Jackson on first down. That one's complete to Tomlinson. That catch good for only a couple. Ball at the 9 on second and 8. To throw is Jackson, escaping the pressure right. And he is into the end zone for a Baltimore touchdown. Lamar Jackson, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Ravens have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. And it's no good. No, he misses the extra point. And our score stays right where it is. Team does its job. The fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we've brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number, kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll set up a third down. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. 3 yards won't be enough here, as that'll bring up fourth down. This late in the game, Charles, I think you maybe seriously have to think about going for it.
Especially where they are in terms of field position, because this is almost like no man's land. Might hurt your punter because there might not be enough space, maybe too far for your field goal kicker. I'm like the old rule. Possession is 9/10 of the law. Possession is 9/10 of winning the game. Go for it, get the first down, close it out.
And down to the 20 he'll go before heading out of bounds. Well, there you go. Save your best scramble of the day for a big-time situation in the fourth quarter, picking up the first.
You don't want to use it up early, right? You want to make sure you save it for that exact moment, that key time. And that's what he did, although you and I both know it wasn't planned that way. But what a nice job using his eyes, scanning the field, and realizing when it was time to exit the pocket and go.
Right back to Mitchell on second down. And they'll work this down to the 15 for a pickup of 4. And now the question everyone's wondering, look at the clock, late fourth quarter, do they put the ball in the air here on third?
I don't. I run the football, and I tell my offensive line, no leakage up front. I don't want my running back hit as I hand the ball off to him. I don't want any type of an issue. But if I am doing the throw, out to the perimeter, maybe one of my best receivers, run a quick slam or something like that.
Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. And a short pickup there down to about the 9. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. Able to stay in bounds, so the clock keeps rolling. This defense right now backed up in the red zone. Another touchdown, it's over. They've got to stand tall quickly.
Been in this spot before. Now there's a little bit of desperation creeping in, and all you're doing when you're talking to your defensive teammates is, first guy there, hold him up. Second, third guy in, rake it the football. Get it out. We've got to create a turnover because one more score, and this game's over.
Play number 9 on the drive coming up, and they need 9 yards on third down. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off at the 15. And he will take this across midfield and down to the 48-yard line.
I love plays like that. A defensive lineman holding the football. It's like a kid who stole a cookie from the cookie jar, and then he's just fleeing the scene of the crime.
And all he's doing in his mind, reliving his days when he was young, probably played fullback on his high school team, always wanted to be the tailback carrying the ball, trying his best to lug that bad boy the distance.
Pretty impressive pick there off the screen, and then a nice return.
You know, nowadays, they do more ball drills with the big guys than ever before because they want to take possessions away from the offense.
Throwing, Jackson, sliding out of the pocket. He's going to look deep for Watkins. And this is caught inside the 5. And he's into the end zone. No flags. It's a touchdown. And now a 2-point conversion. And we'll be tied here in the final minute.
Do they have one big call left? Here we go. The touchdown's massive. But now they've got to have 2 to possibly take this to overtime.
Listen to this crowd now. Their guys need a stop on this 2-point conversion. Jackson to throw. Buying time to his left. And he'll get into the end zone as the 2-point conversion is successful. Couple of teams locked into a good one here. 21 all the score as the kick's away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. They have a little bit of time here to get into field goal range. Not much. A tie game, you don't want to do anything crazy, right?
I agree with you on that one. Risk reward, okay? If you go for it, what is the absolute reward on this? But the risk is probably greater. Run the clock out, get to overtime, and try and win it there.
All right, we'll see if they do just that. The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts, as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in the game. Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. Lance going to throw. That's going to be caught by Samuel. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. Now a final chance to stop it here as a timeout comes in with 10 seconds left in the game. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. On play action, Lance. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Deshaun Elliott. And he will be taken down. And that means we are headed to overtime. And we have free football overtime. Here we go, my friend.
And the way this game played out, this is exactly how it should end. Going to overtime because neither one got an advantage today.
And here in overtime, if the team that receives the ball scores a touchdown, it's over. If they don't, we can still have some more football.
That's exactly right. If they go down and kick a field goal, the other team gets a possession to either match it or score a touchdown to win the ball game. If both teams kick field goals, the next team to score wins. But if the receiving team throws a pick six or fumbles the ball and it gets picked up by the defense and they score, the game is over at that point.
And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. They're set for their first drive here in overtime, and this is where the crowd can really become a factor.
They've had to battle it all day, but I know what you're saying. In overtime, that gets doubled, doesn't it? At least, because now the crowd really wants to be involved and help their team, and that first drive can dictate the whole thing, because they know if this team takes it downfield and scores a touchdown, it's game over.
And it's been loud in here so far. Now Dobbins again on second down. And he'll have a gain of 3 to the 33.
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
Hoping to keep this OT drive alive. Now they face a 3rd and 2. First throw in overtime now for Jackson. Flushed out right. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out.
Well, another fine run right there for Lamar Jackson, and CD, that one puts him over 100 yards now for the ball game.
And remember when all we talked about were 100-yard games from running backs?
Mm-hmm.
That when a quarterback did it, was a surprise. But Lamar Jackson, that's part of the package as well. He'll have as many 100-yard games in the season as the top running backs in the league.
Looking at a 2nd and 11 now after the loss. Now a first throw here in overtime. Rolling to his right. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30.
Containing him is becoming a big problem. We've already seen this once earlier on this drive.
Yeah, and so now 2 times this has happened. Do you adjust something?
Yeah, I think you do. I think you have to start thinking about your rush lanes. Try not to either get too wide or too narrow. Make sure someone is there waiting for him to take off.
And he gets stopped up at the 31 after a gain of maybe a yard.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately, he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
Ballooning the pressure right.
They set up the screen for Dobbins.
And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. It'll be a loss of 6 yards on the play. And they're going to be staring at a 3rd and long here. Steps away. And this effort will not get it done. He stopped well short of the first down at the 29. Give him 8 yards that time on the scramble, and now 4th down. Now Jackson, flush to his right. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the 49ers are going to get the football back. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. Their defense did its job, got the stop. All they need is 3, and this is over.
Couldn't have done much else other than score themselves and end it. But they turned it back over to him, and now all they need is a field goal to win the game. An excellent job by the defense. Can the offense finish things off?
And part one is done, now part two. From the 31, Lance escaping the pressure right. And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down. Charles, in the past, a lot of people call this offense one-dimensional.
I think you did.
Well,
I think it was you.
I'll be honest, I did. I think the fan base is hoping with this young rookie that they can put some wrinkles in this offense like we just saw.
I think you're exactly right, because we did have that discussion that what we've seen in the past from them, They needed to broaden, and they have done it here. Look at what he's bringing to their offense, and now as a defense.
And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes.
Tyus Bowser charging hard from that linebacker spot, and he drops him for a loss of 11.
And he's going to go down again.
Now another timeout called for by the offense. They'll be down to just one remaining as we step aside here in overtime. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. Play action, now it's Lance. He'll buy some time right. Winds up and lets it go for Samuel. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Two things you can do in that situation, run and punt the football or try and take your shot at getting the first down. They chose the latter, but they'll have to punt all the same.
Here comes the 49ers punter now. On for a very important punt here in overtime. Taken in at the 22. And nice work on the return as he gets about 15 yards back. And the Ravens, they'll take over. Jackson out to his left. He's going deep for Brown. Oh, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the safety, Jarquiski Tart. So the OT clock hits zero, and we're still not done. We'll switch sides and need at least one more OT to decide it after this. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll work this forward for about three at second down.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a three-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
Right back to Mitchell on second down.
A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31.
Patrick Green on the tackle. It's a gain of three. Brings up third and four.
On third down, Mitchell. And he'll take this inside the 30 to about the 29, maybe the 28-yard line. They've now produced three-yard gains on three straight plays. Leads us to fourth down. They'll try and run for it. And he's able to get the first here as he's taken down at the 25. And I know you, with every carry, especially in overtime, you're just saying, if you're that ball carrier, hold on to the football.
Hold on to it, protect it, but not necessarily settling, because you're trying to get to the end zone. You're trying to end the game right here. And I know the defensive guys poking, clawing, raking, trying to knock the ball free and protect their end zone.
Yeah, like you alluded to, especially this part of the field.
Lance now on first down.
And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with 2nd and a yard.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
On 2nd down, it's Mitchell, and able to get him down, but he does reach the 5.
15 yards rushing for him now as he was just trying to will his guys to an overtime victory.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And after the good gain last play, this time they say, as he's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. At the 6-yard line. Gonna give this time to the tailback. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not gonna go anywhere. Call it no gain that time, and now it's third and goal. So now it'll all come down to Robbie Gould. This to win it in overtime. And he got it. The kick is good in overtime. He's able to split the uprights. Now a second timeout called for by the defense. They'll be left with just one remaining here at OT. And Charles, I think when the schedule comes out, all teams, no matter where they're predicted to finish, talk about protecting your home turf. They were able to do that here in this one.
Similar to a tennis match, right? Not letting them break your serve. That way you hold on to it. They got it done, and they feel very good about that victory.